Junior Shun held public lecture in honor of the Vice Chancellor in commemoration of the 60th birthday of the Osun State University Vice Chancellor, Professor Labode Pupola. The university held a public lecture to mark the day in the university in Osogbo. The public lecture, which was titled Leadership in a Decadent Society, Treading the Solitary Road, was aimed at enlightening the people on how leadership qualities can be enhanced irrespective of any society we find ourselves. Speaking, the guest speaker of the occasion, Professor Peter Okebukola, who connected virtually, said the essence of the lecture is to remind ourselves the attribute of a decadent society and how a leader is expected to make efforts in transforming better governance. He further urged that if the National University Council should award any leader on stable leadership role and developmental agenda, then Professor Labode Pupola should be considered the best winner. The Pioneer Chancellor of the University, Apostle Dr. Mrs. Folonso Alakija, while giving her address virtually, said a decadent society is a society where corruption is on the increase. She further stated that for a country to transform, it is time to make conservative efforts to stamp out corrupt practices by speaking out irrespective of who is involved. As the event of Ford's cutting of celebrant cake was done and give presentation given to the celebrant by the spiritual officers and members of the university's management. The Vice Chancellor and celebrant of the day, Professor Labode Pupola, in his comment said the public lecture organized for him was a successful coup in disguise because he, as a person, does not fancy elaborate celebration. But this one came as a surprise. He also stated the essence of the lecture while addressing the pressmen.
My own take on this is that, yes, the time has come that we all should accept leadership. You don't have to be a politician to accept leadership. Leadership at the family level, leadership at the institutional level, leadership at the community level. That's the only way we can have a good society. Okay, is it right for me to be corrupt? Is it right for me not to have integrity? So when people talk about it, I have the feeling that, yeah, maybe something is really, really wrong in society. Otherwise, why should we be celebrating somebody because he's not corrupt? I'm not supposed to be corrupt in the first instance. I'm not supposed to be. Nobody's supposed to be corrupt. We are all supposed to have integrity. So when people emphasize it, it means something is missing in society. So I'm just living my life the way my upbringing has been, just to strive to do the right things at all times. I don't play to the gallery, and I actually also don't do anything because I want to be popular. I just do things because I consider them being right. Like I also said in my comments, I'm human. Yes, I have my own faults too, but as much as possible, I work on those inadequacies to ensure that, yes, I do things that be pleasing to the Almighty God, my Creator, and at the same time, pleasing to the society that I choose to serve. Well, Nigeria is also 60 in a couple of days. I'm a few days older than Nigeria. We can only have the country that we have. I have always said it, the problem of this country is more of the negative followership. Everybody tends to blame government. This is a very, very convenient and escapist thing to blame government. Government is overwhelmed all over the world. And who constitute government? It's we. We, the citizens, constitute government. So I would rather talk to Nigerians, followers, let us contextualize our problems. Problems are all over the world, not only in Nigeria. But most of the time we emphasize problems as if Nigeria is the worst country in the world. And I know that Nigeria is not the worst country in the world. I've visited so many countries, and I know that we have a lot to be proud of, a lot to be happy with. But the followership is so negative, and all we talk about is negative things, and you cannot develop a country that way.
The Pro-Chancellor and Chairman University Governing Council, Malam Yusuf Ali, also gave his comment in the program.
And it has put our eyes in a lot of places in society, and all of us would like our people, whether it's still or not, how do you remember us? The things you have to do while you are here. I think as Sisi, Dr. Pupola has had a few of the things people are likely to write if he grows for the next 6 years and then goes away. What are they likely to write about it? What are they likely to say about it? But don't ever think, no matter how old you are, that everybody will accept you. That's not the design of God. So don't get the legacy annoyed, irritated, and disappointed. When you start things to tell that are doing. People see each other and to say, the boss is not necessary or is not doing what is right. As long as you have the approval of that, the creator of God, and the approval of the doctor says it's with you,
you're okay.
Not all night.
And you can do an example of all the movements of God
that you can use. Book in the Bible and the prophets are all 22 books. None of them ever developed the sense of God, even for their living communities. Some of their families, some of their children, by their prophets.
Somebody like Noah.
The son of God is all of them. All others are their brothers. Some of their brothers, like the wife of the Pharaoh. Some of the Pharaoh. You will see it is interesting. So the creed of our duty to work, so that you have something to tell you about that. I believe, I saw, and I was used to. The other one was, the congregation was in, and the congregation was in, you were standing by the cross, you have fulfilled the side of the family, and that blessed you, and we hope you have done that.
The event, which took place inside the Oyinlola's Hall, had the attendance of the university staffs and guests, while others joined virtually. Kayode Ayeni, ABN TV News, Osun State, Nigeria.